Welcome, and welcome back to the latest edition of Brandler Bits. I'm Jeff Brandler. It's been a while, but we have a great episode today, so let's get right to it. One of the biggest issues that I see with people is the issue of control. Now, to me, that's a funny word, control, because everybody thinks that they have it. The irony is we don't. We have a belief that we can control lots of things. And in fact, a lot of the things that we talk about, that we complain about, that upset us the most are the things we have no control of. Cars, traffic, other people, the weather. These are hot topics that come up every single day. We have no control over this, but we like to complain about it. In fact, the idea is that if we could control it, we could make it better. That's the idea. It's a great idea. There's no merit to it. There's no rational logic to it. There's no evidence to it. We just think so. Therefore, it is. In reality, we have the illusion of control. It's like being a sports fan and wearing your favorite sports jersey because it helps your team win. It really doesn't. We just think it does. It's the illusion of control. So here's my challenge for you. Did you have control over waking up this morning? Not really. It's involuntary. When you left to go to work or the store or wherever you went to in the car, did you have control over the car starting? Not really. And as your day went on and on, there are hundreds of examples, traffic lights, people in stores, grocery stores, etc., etc. No, we don't. But what we have is influence. I don't have control over waking up in the morning, but if I live a healthy lifestyle, keep myself in good shape, the odds are in my favor that I will wake up. I don't have control over my car starting because that happens pretty automatically under the hood with combustion and gas and electrical circuitry. But if I keep my car well tuned, put gas in it, do the proper maintenance, chances are pretty good it's going to start. And so we don't have control, but we have influence. You might guess what is the number one thing that we do have control over. That's me. I have control over me. I have control over what I do and what I do with my life and how I spend my life. I have the ability to do that. If I'm controlling me and controlling my life, my lifestyle, my behaviors, my morals, my values, then I can affect the change that occurs in my life. I can change what I can change because I can change me. Now, there is a big jump from can't change others, can't change the universe, can't change all this other stuff, to I can change me. And the battle, metaphorically, the battle systemically, the battle existentially, is accepting my lack of control. And in fact, embracing my lack of control. Embracing that the world is the way it is, and if I embrace that and accept that I have no control over it, then my life gets way less stressful because I'm not trying to control things I have no control over. So I have to first recognize that I have no control. I have to then embrace the fact that I have no control, and then control what I have control over, which is me and what I do and how I do it. And if I do that and do that in a healthy way, I will be happy. I will be less stressed. And all the things that I attempt to control, I won't have to. And paradoxically, I'll be lighter. I'll be freer. And I'll be happier. For comments, questions about today's topic on control, feel free to contact me. Best way is at my website, which is www.changeispossible.org. I'm Jeff Brandler. This is Brandler Bits, and we will see you soon.